Hey, what's going on, Guardians? TBL here, bringing you some more Destiny Rise of Iron coverage on the PlayStation 4. Now, ever since the expansion came out, the number one question you guys have been asking me is, how do I get up to max level? What do I do to increase my light? And thankfully, this is a pretty easily answered question, as there are a ton of ways to get yourself up to relevant light. And so, in today's video, we're going to be giving you a very quick guide to getting up to, at the very least, 365 light and then beyond. Now, there have already been a bunch of guides out there for this, but I'm going to try to make this one quick and easy to understand. So for you Guardians who are stuck out there trying to get your light up to 365 and beyond, hopefully this will be able to help you out. So, alright, let's go ahead and get into this. Now, first things first, when you're leveling your character, there's going to be two light levels that are going to be heavy grind gates for you. It's going to be the two light levels where things are going to be slowing down, and that is 350 light and 365. Once you reach these two light levels, you're going to notice a significant slowdown in your gains until you push past a certain point. But if you know where to get the loot, you should be able to get through those light level gates in no time flat. Now, first things first, for all Guardians underneath light level 340, all you're going to really need to do is just collect blue engrams, which you can get from basically everything in the game. This part is super easy. You can run story quests, strikes, Archon's Forge, really anything, and get blue engrams that will decrypt all the way up to 340 light. Simply playing really any content in the game will get you to at the very least 340, in no time flat. So, if you want to expedite things, get your story missions done, which should get you a significant light level boost, and then just go run normal strikes until you get up to 340 light. The 1-to-1 infusion and relevant light level system that causes weapon and armor engrams to decrypt around your level is really going to help you here. And in no time flat, you'll find yourself sitting at least 340 light. Once you do, we can move on. Now, 340 to 350 is a little bit interesting, because blue engrams can only decrypt up to 340. So you won't be able to rely on those blue engrams so much anymore. So the grind from 340 to 350 seems like it's going to be a little bit tougher, but thankfully we have some options here. Number one, make sure you've got a ton of legendary engrams, and thankfully with the Rise of Iron we've got plenty of ways to get those every single day. The very first thing you're going to want to do is go and pick up a legendary ghost from one of the vendors in the tower. The Vanguard, the Crucible, and the Faction Leaders all have ghosts for sale that are sitting at a hefty 350 light, which is going to be a huge benefit for you as you're trying to get yourself up to that light level. Now, in my personal opinion, I would recommend the Vanguard Ghost Shell, since it's at 350 light and it's sitting at only 75 legendary marks. And compared to the Faction Vendor Ghost, that's a pretty fair price for such a big light gain. So go ahead and pick that thing up when you can. Don't worry so much about class items, you'll be getting a ton of those from both Vanguard and Faction packages. Once you've got your ghost, it's time to get into the strike playlist. Strikes are very unique in that the boss will drop two blues that are already decrypted into weapons or armor that will always be around your light level, at least up to 365. Meaning you can run strikes over and over again, taking out bosses and getting gear that will continually push your light level higher and higher. If you've got a dedicated group of friends and a really coordinated strategy, you can actually simply go to the director and run the 320 light version of the Omnigal Strike. Every time you take her down, she'll drop two blues that will be around your light level, meaning you can just keep taking her out over and over and over again and pushing your light level through the roof. A lot of people actually got to 365 in less than 2 hours by doing this. But if you don't have a mini raid group, you can simply run strikes in the strike playlist until you get to 360. Additionally, legendary drops and engrams will also push your light as high as it can go, so of course getting those is important too. But if you're constantly running content like strikes, you should be getting out of the 350 light gate in no time flat. Once you feel confident enough to handle them, head into the heroic strike playlist, as that will be a fantastic source for items you can use for infusing, skeleton keys, legendaries, and all manner of things. Also, make sure you're popping those three of coins. The odd exotic engram will give you a sizable light boost as well. Alongside Heroic Strikes, you can also run Varix's Challenge of Elders for rewards that will take you up to 365, as well as the Archon's Forge. Archon's Forge is the brand new, somewhat horde mode challenge that's sort of similar to the Court of Oryx from The Taken King. It's a place where you can go, toss in some offerings, and fight increasing waves of enemies before taking down a boss. It's really, really fun when you can get it together, and if you can find a nice group that's running it, well, it's a source for great gains. You get a ton of engrams running those things, and there are some specific legendary weapons and armors that you can only get from the Forge. And they'll also drop at light levels that are around your current light level. So, in summary, from 350 to 365, you're going to be wanting to focus on Heroic Strikes, since they'll get you two blues from the boss that will take you all the way up to 365. Also, Varix Challenge of Elders will get you legendaries that will be around that light level as well, and the Archon's Forge is also a great source. Crucible will also grant you stuff around your light level up to 385, I do believe. So that can also serve as a great source for items if you're more of a PvP sort of player. But once you've gained enough gear to hit 363 or around 365, welcome to endgame. This is where the real grinding starts. Getting weapons, armor, and class items up to 365 will be easy enough. You'll find that around this level, the hardest thing, the biggest thing that's going to be holding your light back, is going to be your ghost as well as your artifact, as those can be the two hardest things to get, and they'll be the number one thing holding you back from reaching light level 370 and beyond as well. Just running through the story should get you an artifact that's at least 350, and you just kind of have to be lucky with your drops to get artifacts beyond that. One good source of them is actually skeleton keys, since when you open the chest at the end of strikes, they have a very decent chance of dropping an artifact that can go all the way up to 385. But you should be waiting to use those skeleton keys until you're 365 light or above. And next up, we're going to be telling you exactly how to push beyond 365 light. So this is where things get tough, because the blue engrams that bosses drop will no longer be able to push you beyond your current light as long as you're 365. Those blues will only go up to 365, and legendary engrams will only decrypt up to 365. So how do you get to 370 and beyond? Well, there's actually a few ways to do it, but they all involve a grind of some kind. Number one, exotic engrams. Those can decrypt all the way up to the max light, well beyond 365. So if you've stockpiled those, congratulations, you'll have a solid way of getting your light level up. Other than that, faction packages are generally the way to go. Dead Orbit, New Monarchy, the Future War Cult, Crucible, and the Vanguard. Leveling all of those up will get you a chance at faction armor, weapons, or chroma armor that can decrypt all the way up to 385 light. So you'll need to head back in and start farming strikes, public missions, or just playing a ton of PvP to try and get yourself some decent armor. Also, Archon's Forge, the legendary weapons and armor that drop from the Archon's Forge, can also go all the way up to 385, I do believe. So if you and your friends have some offerings, head back in there and start grinding away. It can go really quickly in there, and you can get a lot of drops very, very quickly in the Forge. Just make sure that you're paying attention to your inventory and to your postmaster space, as the amount of blues that you get from taking out enemies there can be so crazy that sometimes it overwrites what's in your postmaster very quickly. Also worth noting is that you shouldn't sleep on some of the older vendors in the tower. The Queen's Wrath, as well as Crota's End, also grant you items up to 385. That's right, Eris is finally useful again. By running Crota's End or Court of Oryx and getting Eris rank ups, you can get yourself a chance at 385 artifacts as well as class items, so don't sleep on that. The Queen faction over in the Reef also has items that can go up to 385. So, ranking up with that faction as well as Varix's House of Judgment are also viable options to push you beyond 365. Another great way to get gear beyond 365 light is skeleton key chests. These are the chests that you see at the end of every strike now. If you've got a skeleton key, you can open it up and get a guaranteed chance at either strike-specific loot or an artifact. This provides an interesting opportunity to get a guaranteed piece of legendary gear that's going to be beyond whatever light level you're at right now, at least up to 385. And if you know which strikes drop what loot, you can plan your farming around that and hopefully get the items that you need. For example, if you really need an artifact and you're at about 370 or beyond, try running the Valis to Oryx strike and using your skeleton keys on there. Valis only has one item in the drop pool for that chest, and that's the Treads Upon Stars, so you have a pretty high chance of either getting that or an artifact that will be beyond the light level of what you currently are. So skeleton keys are very important, and if you've got your hands on some right now, hold on to them until you're at least 365 light. Additionally, Crucible is a great way to get gear beyond 365, as the in-game drops for weapons can go all the way up to 385, and while you're doing Crucible, you'll be building towards a faction rank up that can also get you armor that's light level appropriate. Finally, we have the in-game options, which of course are the raid as well as in-game PvP like Trials of Osiris whenever that returns, as well as the Iron Banner. Now, of course, the biggest of this is the raid. You can run that for gear all the way up to 385, and 390 if you happen to get that new shiny exotic pulse rifle. As a matter of fact, the raid is a fantastic source for loot, since if you're a lower light character, you can just run the first two phases without too much trouble and get your hands on some pretty good stuff. And even if you're not too much of a raider, don't be afraid to try it out by heading into a stream or onto LFG. It's a lot of fun and it's well worth the grind. And if you make use of all these sources of loot, you should be pushing past the 365 light gate in no time flat. But alright, there we go, Guardians. That's a basic outline for how to get yourself up to 365 light and beyond. Again, a quick roundup would be, from whatever light you're at to 340, you can just run story missions or really any content that gives you blue engrams and decrypt them up to 340. From 340 to 350, there are tons of items for sale in the tower that you can buy that will give you a hefty boost to your light. Most important of which is the Vanguard Ghost Shell, which does start at 350. If you've got a ton of legendary marks, then you can also buy some weapons and armor to give you a little bit of a hand there. Other than that, you can just run content like Strikes, which will push your light all the way to 350. From 350 to 365, Heroic Strikes are going to be your best friend, as not only do they grant you blue weapons and armor that can push you all the way to 365, but they'll also give you a chance at legendary drops, skeleton keys, and of course 3 of coin usage, which can get you exotics. And if you're not really feeling up to doing heroics, you can run 320 versions of Strikes to get gear up to 365 as well. So don't feel pressured into the heroic playlist if you don't think you can handle it. And from 365 and beyond, it's time to turn in those faction packages. Getting rep with all the factions, whether it's New Monarchy, Dead Orbit, or Future War Cult, as well as the stuff like the Vanguard and the Crucible, Queen's Wrath, Crota's End, and the House of Judgment will all get you gear up to 365 and beyond. But alright, there you go, Guardians. Now get out there, make your light gains, and get to the max level. Hopefully this answered some of you guys' questions, and if you've got even better ways to level, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. But alright, that's going to be it for this one, guys. Thanks so much for watching. And as always, I am the Black Link. You Guardians, stay frosty.